The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Margaret died with Christ, who rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
Peace, for if to others Indeed, they seem punished. It is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in a furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Second reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, you are unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
So that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
To Marianne and Lauren, Tom and Rachel, Lou and Andrea, and Colleen and Mike. On behalf of Deacon Tom, St. Wenceslaus Parish, and the entire Archangels Cluster, I would like to extend our prayers and sympathies to you at this time. While we mourn the death of Barbara, we commend her to the Lord. I was blessed to have been able to celebrate a few sacraments with her when she was at the Westview Care Center in Britain, and had the opportunity to anoint her on Sunday afternoon. Barbara lived through a lot of change in her life. She grew up in the Great Depression, was a teenager when America was brought into World War II, was a switchboard operator, and saw the rise of technology, and so much more. She saw a lot of change, and continued to adapt and adopt what was needed and good. This was even reflected in her plans for her funeral. At the top it read, Time changes things, so my family may have to adjust these plans. No problems, change whatever is needed. But she was a timeless person when it came to faith, and from that aspect, all was well. Our readings remind us of the life to come, that we are pilgrims in this world journeying towards our eternal home. The life we lead is a response to the invitation of God to be joined with him for eternity. We are tried in this world, each in our own way, and we are called to respond to the grace God gives to each of us. Barbara lived through a lot of transition in our world, up and down, time and again, but she kept her faith in God and trusted in his providential care for her. She not only did the expected church things, she helped the church be a place of communion beyond Mass. She helped organize the first publication of the St. Wenceslaus cookbook that is still in print to this day, and in use to this day. I even have a copy of it at the rectory. She knew the Lord's call to serve, and she answered that call. Barbara put her trust in the Lord and followed him. She knew the gifts and talents God had given her and never ceased using them to benefit others. She believed her faith that death is not something to fear, but something that leads us to everlasting life. Barbara chose the readings purposefully, and our second reading reminds us that we are baptized into the death of Christ so that we might live in the reality of the resurrection now, not in some distant future, but today. That while our world is not perfect, we can live our lives in the resurrection rather than in the life of old. We were baptized into the death of Christ so that as we sacramentally rise from the waters of baptism, we put on Christ and live in the fullness of God's love for us. Barbara knew this love and shared it through the different things that centered around her faith and the faith community she lived in. She saw what God was doing in her life and tried to imitate it. She tried to live it out with a generous heart. She was a very generous and grateful and charitable woman. She was faithful and committed, but she also enjoyed to have fun in life. This I noticed at the bottom of the funeral planning sheet. It says, date completed on the form. And she puts, "You'll never know." Not only that, she put 4 exclamation points behind it. I wonder if that meant all of the kids, reminding them that you'll never know. Barbara has gone to the Lord, and our prayer today is for her. We have a firm hope that as her faith united her to the people of God on earth, that her faith may unite her now to our Father in heaven. She followed where her master had gone before, and we pray that she be admitted to the halls of the saints. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace.
Amen.
God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people. For Barbara, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord. Our sister Barbara was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord. For the family and friends of Barbara, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord of compassion and the giver of consolation, we pray to the Lord. For our departed relatives and friends, we pray especially for Barbara's parents, John and Mary, her husband Louis, her brothers Leo, Walter, Donald, John, and Cletus, and her sisters Veronica, Doris, and Rosemary. May they welcome her with Christ to their everlasting home in the kingdom of heaven. We pray to the Lord. For all of us assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for Barbara, strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. We pray to the Lord. Loving God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for Barbara and all our departed brothers and sisters. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the heavenly kingdom through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated as we prepare the altar.
Number 818, Here I Am, Lord.
Thank you.
sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Barbara, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. So that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Barbara, whom you have called from this world to herself. Grant that she, who is united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Stress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
let us offer each other a sign. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. For those who are not receiving communion, you can either remain in the pew, or you can come forward with your arms crossed and receive a blessing.
Number 481, Hail Mary, Gentlewoman.
Let us pray. Lord
Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Barbara may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Barbara, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Barbara again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console with one another in the faith of Christ Jesus. Signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
Number 614, How Great Thou Art.
Thank you.
Our sister Barbara has gone to rest in Jesus Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's true in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our sister. Together may we meet in Christ Jesus, when he who is our life appears, Lord. We read in sacred scripture, our citizenship is in heaven, and from it we also await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Almighty and everly God, remember the mercy with which you graced your servant Barbara in life. Receive her, we pray, into the visions of the saints. As we make ready our sister's resting place, look also with favor on those who mourn, and comfort them in their loss. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Ensure the certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. We commend Almighty God our sister Barbara, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace. Dear friends, in reverence, let us pray to God, the source of all mercies. The response is, hear our prayer. Gracious Lord, forgive the sins of those who have died in Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Remember all the good they have done. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Welcome them into eternal life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for those who mourn. Comfort them in their grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lighten their sense of loss with your presence. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Increase their faith and strengthen their hope. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray also for ourselves, our pilgrimage through life. Keep us faithful in your service. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Kindle in our hearts a longing for heaven. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And with longing for the coming of God's kingdom, we pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you destroyed our death, and with his rest in the tomb, you have hallowed the graves of all who believe in you. And through his rising again, you restored us to eternal life. God of the living and the dead, accept our prayers for those who have died in Christ, and are buried with you in the hope of rising again. Since they were true to your name on earth, let them praise you forever in the joy of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
Amen. The church of the
honor. May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
And may the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God.